I'm okay. If you really come around my way.
Standing on this mountain, looking over LA at the break of day.
Out of Cali with a big bitch, fucking the same bitch. The man saving up late.
LA
saving up late. Out of Cali with a bang, bitch, fucking insane, bitch.
Yo, the man saving L.A. I rock the California state flag over my face. 818 taking over, gotta notice the flow, bruh. I caught a little break with Shinoda and Hova. But out the mixtape of Green Lantern with smash hits. The song I did with Jules Santana was bad shit. Fact is, I'm nasty, in need of a sponge bath. I make you make a face like you sniffing a skunk's ass. Mash out, motherfuckers better know the program pronto. I'll kill your boss off, make your capo compost. If dudes wanna fuck around, fine, I'm chillin'. You may have a couple nines, but I got a few bajillion. It's that lavish after mathematics, in the home of fine wine and cash addicts. You want static? We can handle it simple. A couple batteries and jumper cables hooked to your nipples, I'm fine.
LA, LA, that's where I stay. And we ride on the things like every day.
Bitch, the man saving up late, so watch what you say. Saving up late,
I'm here to save the day.
Out of Cali with a bang, bitch, fucking insane, bitch.
Is it LA or is it entourage? Actors acting like gangsters, rappers wrapped up in facades. Stuck up models and bras, stuck on Hollywood's mirage. Keep your fingers down their throats, trying to keep a model size. Sunshine, this is where the ballers live. But hit my side of town, this is where they'll rob you quick. Carson Cali, you can take the 110 to the 91 East and hop off of Wilmington. Compton's next door, Long Beach on the other side. Harbor City, San Pedro, extra 5-minute ride. Peace to my Mexicans, Samoans, Cambodians, Asians, even a few white boys in the hood hanging, blowing kush, riding charges and harness.
This is the grand final for the men's open weight double at the USRowing Youth National Championships for 2014. Six boats currently on the course. All boats past the breakage area, coming up to 250 meters in. All crews within contact of each other. No one has jumped out to a big lead yet. We do some of these small boats right out of the gate. You have someone that establishes a wide lead very early on, but right now we still have all crews right next to each other. I'm going to give a very slight advantage to lane two, Saugatuck. Saugatuck being flanked by Brookline High School in lane one. Brookline High School slipping back to fourth. But as we come up to the halfway point, these bottom three boats, Brookline, Baltimore, and River City, charging each other to try and stay within contact of each other. 1,000 meters to go in the grand final for the men's double.
Halfway to the finish line for the championship and the medal here in the men's double at the 2014 U.S. Rowing Youth National Championships. It is Saugatuck out with a lead, but my, what a battle going on behind. At each stroke, you can see Rye and Miami trading for that second place. Wonderful to see the competitors check each other out. And here comes Rye pouring it on, and it's an advantage to Rye right now for second place. Saugatuck still in the lead, but Rye leading in second with Miami, but making a move there on the opposite side of the course from the camera is the boat from Brookline. Baltimore, in the meantime, is still in fifth, and River City in sixth. Miami may have lost a lot of their energy because it appears that the boat from Brookline that had been in fourth has begun to make a move and is trying to pass them. In the meantime, Saugatuck still out front. This is for the gold medal here in the men's double at these national championships. Saugatuck holding on right now, but in second place, it's the boat from Rye in lane four. With Miami being challenged for third place from the Brookline. But in the meantime, Brookline, there in lane one, has begun to walk up on all these other boats. They have been lingering back in fourth place, but they are beginning to make a move. In the meantime, Miami, seeing those challenges, is trying to pick up the pace, but it looks like they are losing a little. We'll have to see how it works out as they're about 300 meters from the end. Right now, it's Saugatuck. This is for the grand final right now. Saugatuck in the lead, being challenged from that boat from Rye here in the men's double. They're looking for that gold medal. Can Saugatuck hold on? We'll have to wait and see, but Rye is making a hard charge. Brookline pouring on the power to their oars, catching up with Miami. In the meantime, in the back there's Baltimore and River City as they're coming in there. But right now, we'll have to see how it all works out as they hit those red buoys in the final 250 meters of this grand final at the 2014 U.S. Rowing Youth National Championships. Look at these rowers go. Brookline continuing to charge, but look at Rye pour it on. Rye out in lane four is beginning to move, and they have taken over first place. In the meantime, seeing that challenge, Saugatuck trying to reapply themselves. Brookline is charging. Miami is charging towards the finish. But at the finish, it is the boat from Saugatuck maintaining gold medals with the boat from Rye. It looks like in second, Brookline in third. And we'll have to see how the rest of the field works out as the last boat, the boat from River City, crosses in sixth.
The B-level final for the men's lightweight youth four is underway and past 250 meters here at the U.S. Rowing Youth National Championships for lane four, Brookline High School. So Brookline sitting in fifth, and they have bowed astern over lane six, Everett Rowing Association, just outside of the Seattle area. And now Waylon Weston has pulled into a pretty solid lead here with three seats over Skyline. Skyline sitting in second, but being paced by Cincinnati Juniors. And then with Mercer hot on their heels. So really nice racing here from these top five boats. That fifth place position does still belong to Brookline High School out of lane four. And then back by half a length of open water, it is Everett in that sixth place position. 750 meters in, Waylon Weston with the lead. And now Cincinnati moving into that second place spot. Cincinnati here in second place by two seats over Skyline Crew. And Skyline looking over their starboard side at lane five, Mercer. Mercer looking to try and pull even with Skyline for that third place spot, as well as Brookline High School. So really tight racing here for that third or fourth place position.
Waylon Weston out in the lead, but a tight pack here. Waylon Weston, Skyline, Cincinnati Juniors, Mercer, all in the mix. Mercer and also Brookline and Everett Rowing, but they're a wee bit off track. But out in front right now, it is a battle. Looks like Brookline is moving into the mix as well, but Cincinnati Junior's in the lead. Waylon Weston in second and Brookline in third for the moment. Skyline, that was looking good, has fell off the pace some. It's Brookline being the mover and shaker right now, but Cincinnati Juniors are holding on to the lead here in the petite final for the men's lightweight fours. They have about a half a deck length lead over the Waylon Weston boat in lane three, with Brookline stalking them in lane four right now. Brookline in third right now, beginning to walk up on that Waylon Weston boat as well. That bow very prominent in the side of the stroke for the Waylon Weston boat. The Cincinnati Juniors continue to pour it on, and they are pulling away from the boat from Waylon Weston. In the meantime, Brookline beginning to ease up on Waylon Weston as well, as they are 250 meters from the finish. Battling a slight headwind here in Lake Natoma today, that Look at all the delta winds here in Sacramento beginning to blow. The Cincinnati Juniors continuing to power towards the finish line. Waylon Weston has anything left. They may try to catch him. But look at these four boats going across right here. Cincinnati Juniors in first. Waylon Weston in second. Brookline in third right now. PNRA Mercer in the mix as well. And it looks like Waylon Weston's trying to make a move on the juniors, but the juniors begin to pull with more power and surge forward at the finish. It's the Cincinnati Juniors winning the B final, followed by Waylon Weston, then Brookline, Mercer, Skyline.
And we have a start in the CDO final for the men's lightweight youth 8 here at the USRowing Youth National Championships for 2014. All crews coming through the breakage area. We do have 8 boats on the water for this race, so we'll keep our eye on all of them and try to get them in order for you. Right now, all boats are still tightly packed as we come up to the 250-meter point. But we've got a very early leader out of lane one. That is OARS. And Orr's crew with a one-length lead, almost a little bit of open water for them over Mount Baker. So Mount Baker rowing out of lane two with a slight lead over Community Rowing. Community Rowing in third, slight lead over Brookline High School in lane four. But with Green Lake right there with them. So Green Lake actually surging ahead of Brookline High School for that fourth place position. So in that second place spot, it is Mount Baker. They're followed by lane five, Green Lake. Mount Baker and Green Lake, crosstown rivals. Fourth place is gonna go back inside to Community Rowing. And then Brookline High School right behind them. That sixth place position, it is lane six, Canisius, followed by Arlington Belmont crew in seventh, and then Mountain Lakes in eighth place. So Greenland Lake and Mountain Baker vying for that second place position. I'm gonna give the advantage right now to Green Lake with Mountain Baker in third. They're followed by lane three, Community Rowing. And then Brookline High School right next to them. In lane six, it is Canisius in that sixth place position.
Let's go for Brookline. Take it. Nobody can take this from you. Nobody will take this from you. Long shot. Ratio, points 145 to split. You gotta get it down. See your eyes walking. You gotta go now. Canisius has a seat.
Looks like right now it's Green Lake that has the advantage over Brookline.
Boys, we gotta get
for that fourth place.
Breathe.
But back and forth and back and forth.
Let starboard, you gotta set it up now. Starboard down. Good. Every stroke you have taken for this. 10:34, a little faster with the head. Last 250 till the halfway.
The clamor of the coxswains in these eights is incredible. Just to hear them coming down the course. Sometimes pity the rowers that are in their boats getting screamed at.
Five! And four! And three! And two! And one! Sting them! Break them!
Look at all those rowers lined up right across the course. 300 meters from the finish.
This lineup.
And as we've
last
seen today, it ain't over till it's over because these boats can move fast.
Waves.
A long way in a short amount of time. As they hit the 250 meters to go mark, it's becoming quite a battle as the boats line up across the course.
You gotta go now. Go!
Just because you're leading that 250 meters doesn't guarantee that you're gonna win.
It's worth it! Move!
Green Lake boats coxswain is urging the rowers onward. Here comes oars.
Nine, eight, seven,
to fight their way
six,
out in lane
five,
six, Canisius trying to come back at
three,
the finish line by
two,
just a few feet. It is the oars boat in lane
go.
One, followed by Mount Baker, Community Rowers.
Go.
A fourth place to call between Brookline and Canisius, then Green Lake.
Check my wristwatch, it's a quarter to five, I need the last pick.